Showered and had breakfast, so I finally have enough energy to introduce myself. My name is Sydney. I am a 23-year-old realtor and homeowner in the Tampa Bay area. I thought I would do a realistic day in the life as a new agent because whenever I watch the videos, it's kind of like on their busy day that they're having listing appointments or writing an offer, and that's just not really realistic for every single day, and it can be discouraging as a first year agent. So I kind of want to do a realistic day in my life on what I do, and hope you guys like it. So first thing that I'm actually not doing today, but I usually do about once a week, is meet up with my team. We usually talk about our situations that we're in, clients' needs, mastermind, and I think that joining a group is probably one of the best things to do, especially if you're thinking about joining real estate. You want to surround yourself by successful people and agents that you want to be like so that you can grow your business. So you always want to make sure that you are connecting. But enough of that, let's get into doing a home tour. Okay, so we just made it to the house in Palm Harbor where we're gonna be doing our home tour, and I think that home tours are a great thing to do for your first year in real estate because maybe you don't have a listing at the time and you wanna create content for social media and you wanna show that you know the area or the market. And so for that reason, I try to do home tours maybe like once a month for those reasons, either by myself or with my team. But yeah, let's get into it. So I just got back to my house and I'm gonna work on editing the videos for TikTok, YouTube, Instagram, you name it. But let's eat first and then we're gonna work on some market updates for farming areas. That's some. So farming is something that I'm still kind of trying to get used to, trying to try out, but mainly it's you sticking to a neighborhood that you want to be an expert in. Basically, the end game of farming is to have multiple for sale signs in a neighborhood and people calling you left and right because that is your neighborhood. So you gotta think, if you're driving down a street and you see, you know, for sale by city, for sale by city, for sale by city, most likely the neighbors are gonna be like, she has a bunch of houses, she really knows about this neighborhood, and they're gonna give you a call. You're becoming the expert in that area, meaning you're gonna get more business, more clientele, and be more productive. So overall, it's really good. It's a proactive way of getting in the area. It's a protective way of getting your face out there. So I'm gonna work on mine, and then I'll kind of give you guys a sneak peek later. Already, I just finished. It's more of a market update more than anything, but I kind of just introduce myself and then I talk about the homes that I've sold recently, the homes that are pending, and the ones that are active, and then like the average sales price so they can kind of get an idea. And then at the end, I always say, you know, what's your property worth, and leave a link below so that they can kind of get an idea of maybe what theirs could sell for, and then it could eventually lead to a listing appointment for you. So I'll give you a quick sneak peek of what mine looks like. All right. Alright, so it is now 6 o'clock, so I'm basically done with my work day. Your first year of real estate can be really confusing, so I kind of wanted to talk about this book that I read every night. It's called Real Estate Prospecting, and I usually read about 1 to 2 chapters a night before I go to bed, and it really sets up my to-do list for the next day. So if you haven't read it and you're going into your first year or in your first year, then get it now and read it, because it has helped me out tremendously. For right now, I'm going to make dinner, watch 90 Day Fiancé with my boyfriend, read my book, make my to-do list, and go to bed. So I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye!
Go.
Before we get started, I wanted to introduce that. I forgot the words. Let me think. Oh, yeah, okay.